Welcome to our lecture online. Now let's take a look at the diurnal temperature range. What do we mean by the diurnal temperature range? Well, it turns out that typically early in the morning, any location experiences its coldest temperature. We used to think as kids that the coldest time of the night would be like maybe at midnight, but that's not the case because all throughout the night, the temperature continues to decrease. Because there's no influx of heat, the sun isn't shining, and slowly the heat is leaking from the lower troposphere into higher regions of the troposphere, and so the temperature is slowly decreasing until the sun comes up over the horizon, begins to shine again, and starts adding more energy to the lower troposphere. So typically, 6 o'clock in the morning is about the coldest time of the day. Depends upon summer, winter, of course. And then once the sun begins to shine, the temperature begins to go up higher and higher and higher. And eventually we reach a maximum temperature for the day. That's typically past the noon hour. Again, even though the sun is at its highest point around noon, the sun is still adding a lot more energy even in the hours after noon, 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock in the afternoon. And so more heat is being added compared to the amount of heat that's leaking away from the lower troposphere into the higher regions of the troposphere. So the temperature continues to increase until the amount of heat received from the sun, and of course indirectly because the heat is received from the sun, it is absorbed by the surface, and that 5.5% that gets re-radiated into the lower troposphere that the greenhouse gases absorb, that's the heating effect. And so when the amount of heat added to that lower troposphere through that effect begins to balance out with the amount of heat that's leaving the lower troposphere into the higher regions, at that point the temperature begins to, the temperature stabilizes, and then the temperature begins to decrease as the rate of the heat disappearing out of the lower troposphere is greater than the amount of heat that the sun can provide. And so then things begin to cool down. After the sun sets, that process continues, and eventually when we get to about the 6 o'clock of the next day, we reach the lowest temperature again, and then the sun rises and it starts all over again. The difference between the highest temperature during the daytime and the lowest temperature during the nighttime is called the diurnal temperature range. And it turns out that can be a very small number and that can be a very big number. So there's some very big factors affecting that range. Notice the range can be anywhere from about 5 degrees Fahrenheit, or 5 Fahrenheit degrees, I should say, to about 50 Fahrenheit degrees, which is about 3 centigrade degrees to about 28 centigrade degrees or Celsius degrees. Of course, it can even be higher and lower under certain special circumstances, but you can see that there's a tremendous difference in that diurnal temperature range. And we'll talk about why that difference exists. Now, what we need to realize is that the smaller that range, the smaller the diurnal temperature range, the more heat is being kept in, because then the heat leaks out much more slowly, which means that the greenhouse gases are therefore much more effective. But if the temperature drops rather quickly, the larger the range, because as the temperature drops more quickly, you're going to have a much bigger range between daytime and nighttime temperatures. That means that less heat is being kept in and the greenhouse gases are therefore less effective. Now, what would cause that enormous difference? We know that there's 5 major greenhouse gases. We have water vapor, we have carbon dioxide, we have ozone, we have methane, and we have nitrous oxide. And the 2 major ones, of course, are water vapor and carbon dioxide. But only one of those 5 can vary tremendously in the atmospheric concentration. The other 5, from day to day, from night to night, from week to week, from even from year to year, there are only very small differences in the concentration of all those other greenhouse gases. We do see changes and we keep track of those, but it's only the water vapor that can have very large differences in the concentration from night to night, from day to day, from week to week, month to month, and for different locations on the Earth, which is not the case for the other greenhouse gases. So there's probably a strong relationship between the very large differences in the diurnal temperature range and the concentration of the water vapor. And as we had seen in previous videos, it appeared that water vapor was by far the most important greenhouse gas, perhaps responsible for over 90% of the greenhouse effect. And this diurnal temperature range seems to bear that out. So we're going to discuss that a little bit more in the videos to come to try to understand why there's such a big difference in the diurnal range. Again, what we need to understand here, that it's all about the rate at which heat can go from the lower troposphere, where the greenhouse gases basically absorb almost 100% of the available energy that can be absorbed, that's being radiated from the Earth in the first few hundred meters of troposphere, and then that heat slowly makes its way to the upper reaches of the troposphere, where it then gets radiated into space. Of course, if that happens very slowly, if the greenhouse gases keep it in very well, then we have a very small range. If the greenhouse gases are not able to hang on to heat very well and the heat transfer quickly through the troposphere, then we have a much larger range in the diurnal temperature range. So that's the key here to understand, and we'll take a look at more details about what's really causing those vast ranges and what that really means in terms of what we call the effectiveness of greenhouse gases and which greenhouse gas is really responsible for this. And that's how we know.